This video is going to cover how to find slope. I am going to have three different examples and three different types of problems in how you could find slope. The first being how to find slope when you're given a graph. So here we have a graph to use and we are asked to find slope. Okay, so if we are asked to find slope graphically, what we're going to want to do is we're going to want to at least have two points picked out on our graph. So I have these two points labeled right over here, or I have these two points picked out, and those are the two points that we're going to use in order to calculate slope. As long as we have two points, that means that we can use the slope formula. And the slope formula, remember, says this: m is equal to y2 minus y1 over x2 minus x1. So what we're going to do is we're going to pick out our two points. So our first point, I'm just going to say, is this top point right over here. And if we pick out the coordinates for that, we would get 0, 3. Also, this bottom point right over here, this point would be 1, 0. Remember, when it comes to points, it's always in reference from the origin. So for example, this top point, 0, 3, that first point is your x value, so from the origin, we would not be moving left or right, but we would be going straight up 3, and that's what those coordinates represent. For the 1, 0, so from the origin, we would be moving 1 to the right and then staying put there. So then, I'm going to label the top one my x1, y1, and I'm going to label this bottom point x2, y2. It does not matter which one is x1, y1, which one is x2, y2. Had I decided to switch the positions completely around, I would still get to the same exact answer. So it does not matter which positions they go in. Just choose one to be the first, the other one to be the second point. Otherwise, just plug and chug directly into the formula. So this formula, starting in the numerator, says y2 minus y1. So y2 is 0 minus y1, which is 3, over x2 minus x1. So x2 is 1 minus x1, which is 0. The next thing to do would be to simplify the subtraction here. So in the numerator, 0 minus 3 is a negative 3, and 1 minus 0 is 1. So here, simplifying our slope even further down, any number over 1 is just that same number. So negative 3 divided by 1 is simply just negative 3. So our second example of finding slope looks like this. Find slope when we're given two points. So if we're going to find slope given two points, this is actually partway through the last problem here. We're already given the two points. We don't have to pick them out from a graph. We don't have to find them in an equation. We know exactly what our two points are. So the first thing I would do is go ahead and just label your two points here. I'm going to say that this first point here, this negative 4, 6, is x1, y1. And I'm going to say that negative 1, negative 2, this is going to be my x2, y2. Okay, so otherwise I am going to use that same slope formula that says slope is equal to y2 minus y1 over x2 minus x1. So again, I'm just going to plug and chug directly into this formula. So y2, for my particular example here, is a negative 2, minus y1, which is a 6, over x2, which is negative 1, minus x1, which is negative 4. We need to go ahead and take care of our subtraction here. So in the numerator, we have negative 2 minus 6, which is a negative 8. Or remember, if you're a negative $2 in your bank account and you spend $6 more, you are further down, you would now be at a negative 8. In the denominator, we do have these two negatives side by side, which means we have our double negative rule. Those will cancel into a positive, leaving us with negative 1 plus 4, which is a 3. Or again, think about it in terms of money. If you have negative $1 in your bank account and you add 4, you're now up $3. Check to see if your fraction can be simplified. So here we have a negative 8/3. 8 has nothing in common with the 3. There's no negatives or anything that will cancel out any further. So here our slope is a negative 8/3. So that means our line would be generally going in the negative direction, and it would be rising 8, running 3. So it'd be going up 8 over 3, up 8 over 3. Okay, so the last example that I have of finding slope is finding slope when you're given an equation. So when we're given an equation, the best way, in my opinion, in order to find slope is to use the slope-intercept form, which is y is equal to mx plus b. And the reason why I think this is because as long as we have it in the proper form, so as long as we solve our equation for y, all I have to do is find m, which is my coefficient of x, and that's my slope. That's literally all I have to do. All I have to do is pick it out of the equation. But first, it needs to be in this form, which means I need to solve for y and get that y all by itself. So for this particular equation, it's not that bad getting y all by itself. Here's y. In order to get it by itself, I need to get rid of the 2x. That 2x is positive, which means I'm going to do the opposite and subtract it away. So on the left-hand side, 2x minus 2x cancels. I'm going to drop down y. Is equal to, again, to have it just in proper form, the x should be in front of the number. So I'm going to drop down that minus 2x first, and then this positive 10 over here, I'm going to drop it down behind it. So my equation is already solved for y. The only thing left to do is to pick out what our slope is. So our slope is our coefficient of x. So here's x. My coefficient is a negative 2. Therefore, just by definition of what this formula states here, I can say that slope is negative 2. It really is as simple as that, as picking it out of the equation as long as we have it in the proper form. So what this tells me is I do have a negative slope. Negative 2, represented as a fraction, would look like negative 2 over 1. That means I'm going to be rising 2. Running 1. So this looks like up 2 over 1, up 2 over 1 in the negative direction.